20 years.
So that was 20 years?
Yeah.
Oh, that's awesome.
Yeah. Playing about 40.
I played everything. I played community hockey, I played football, basketball.
Oh, wow.
But when I got your age, how old are you? Okay, younger than you. When I got to be about 22, done with hockey, kind of just still playing pickup basketball, right? You've done all of your school stuff.
Yes.
So I said, okay, I need another sport. So I started playing golf with a buddy of mine. And I was decent, kind of mid-80s. The guy I was playing with was a low 70s, never had a lesson in his life. Unbelievable. He's actually the best athlete I've ever played. He could have been an NHL player. He just had no desire. He was one of those guys who no competitive drive, right? So it drove me nuts because I would have loved to have been an NHL player. Didn't have his skill. Right? So we played golf for a few years, but it was slow. Like we played 36. Run. One swing, hit the ball, carry the ball, the bag, run, you know. So we do. It kind of got me. So I took up tennis. Realized that tennis is probably the hardest sport I ever played.
Really?
Yeah. Right. And, you know, when you look at the pros, they make it look easy. It's not easy. And we'll go into some of those details and you'll see that today. I probably had 100 to 150 lessons with a Davis Cup player. There used to be this international chain called Peter Burwash International that trained pros that worked at resorts all over the Caribbean and all over. So this guy was a train-the-trainer guy. So those two really good guys. I'm kind of a good average player. I play inter-county. I play, kind of A&B. I'm 6 years old, so still going strong. Still beating 30-year-old guys.
Some days.
But I love to teach and I understand, the fundamentals of what people do. And, I've been teaching long enough to see what people typically do wrong. And usually it's just little adjustments that all of a sudden move your game up a notch. So what we're going to do, we'll just start out rallying on one of the forehands and backhands. And we'll go from there.
Okay,
awesome. Spot.
hits it almost like a golf shot.
Yeah.
Nice high sky ball. Fly ball. Yeah. Can't hit it. Very focused. West Coast is super strong. Big monster guy.
Ortiz.
They can do it because they're just so strong and they have all the resolution.
Yeah.
But the ordinary guy, if it's below that, you can't really make it. A high ball, what happens? Pitchers get a lot of guys out of the field. Infield ground balls or infield balls. So we want to try and avoid hitting balls above our left. So the basic setup that I do with teams you approach is, I call it the run. Imagine you're running this ball, run, stop. Thank you. you don't want to give this away, and you want to use your lower body to twist. Right? So, let's try and get that just up. So imagine that these are numbers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, maybe a little bit more. Your back top knuckle should be either on one or kind of one or two. Right? Because on our forehand, our knuckles on number three. Right? Yeah, so maybe even a little more. Let's just try it there. Put your other hand in there. I'm going to give you a couple little clues. I'm going to say drop the racket there. Right? So now, the next thing I want you to do is bend your elbows over. Try and get this kind of... So imagine this. I've got the racket right in front of me. If you do this, imagine you did that. How much push do you have left?
Not much.
None. Right, you're bunting. It's almost like you're hitting. Right. Like when we hit a baseball, we kind of do that. But in tennis, we want to make contact where we still have some rotation left of our hips, our shoulders, right? And I don't want the elbows locked, because what we can do is imagine you got a bad bounce. Imagine you got a bad bounce and the ball came into you. You could pull it in and still make a shot. If it bounced away from you, you could push it out and still make a shot. But if you get your elbows locked, you're not going to have time to do that. Right. Okay. So one, slightly out. Yeah, there. So now I'm going to pull your weight forward. So you should feel it in your left quad. So we're going to get this, we're going to start from here, step out, to there, and we're going to practice cross court, because that's the shot. You play with your mental? Okay.
There we go, that's
forehand.
Almost everybody has
forehand. Forehand, and everybody's weakness. Most players like this. After today, you're going to go to the back. So you want to hit to the weakness, which is their backhand. Right? I see public court guys rally back and forth, rockets, and I go up to them and I say, you know, that's all good though. When I play you, I'm going to hit every ball to your backhand. If you don't practice it, and you can't make that shot. If you do something with your backhand, that's all you need. Right? So, practice hitting it there. So here, you're just being bent, right? Coil.
step out. So we're sort of facing the east, that's where we're going to start. We'll work from the ready position now. Runner's position. Exactly the same thing from this, from the baseline. So I want you to get your hands just a little bit closer together.
Maybe you mean like these two hands?
Yeah, so I literally move that one down, move this one just a little bit, almost like that. Yeah. All right, so where's your knuckle?
My knuckle?
Oh.
Well, it was here.
This knuckle.
Oh, this knuckle, that's right.
And so imagine, one last little thing.
Sure.
I'll give you a drive.
Like car, yes.
Okay, so when you're learning to drive, they said, check the left, check the rear, check the right, check your blind spots, check the speedometer, check the gas.
Yes.
A month later, it's all automatic.
Yes.
So today, I'm giving you all of this information,
yep.
And in a couple weeks, you're not going to have to think,
right.
Okay, where is my knuckle? Okay, where is my racket? You want to assimilate that to a habit,
yes.
Right?
Yep.
So we're just getting the feel of that, right? So, step out. So, if your grip is wrong, we're going on. At contact, we want our racket to be neutral.
Okay.
It's open.
Yes.
So we don't need the racket to be closed to get top spin. We are going to generate top spin by going from low to high and brush up brush up the back of the ball, right? But we need to be vertical. If we're closed, it's in the net.
Yeah.
And we don't want the ball.
So the point of contact is the point of this feet, or is it just typically like...
Well, it's slightly ahead of the foot to go cross court. To go down the line. There. And it's different
depending on
where your direction is, right? So we're going to make two changes. The only two changes we're going to make is where you step. If you're going to go cross court,
then you want it to be more this.
Right.
And if you want to go here, you want to go down.
Even more forward.
More,
yeah.
Forward, yeah.
But there.
But there.
And hit the ball late.
Right.
Because,
yeah, because the ball will, compared to here and here, you're getting to the different time.
Right.
Yeah.
So there's cross court.
Yeah.
There's down the line. Right. And right now, we're just going to practice cross court.
Sure.
Okay. So runner's position. So make sure that you're not using your wrists.
Right. Okay.
Your wrist is strongest when it's straight. It's not strong, you don't want to be doing that, you don't want to be doing that, right straight.
Okay.
So we want, for the racket to be vertical out front, it needs to be slightly faced down behind you. Because by the time you come out, now it's vertical. If it's vertical here, by the time you get out front, it's open. So we want slightly closed behind you. Me. Of where the racket should be in the runner's position.
Right.
I call this the set position. Okay. Everybody watches it on TV,
yeah,
and thinks that every ball is skimming the net.
Yeah.
Not at all.
I was very surprised.
Nadal's balls are easily 5 or 6 feet off the
yeah.
court, but he's spinning them at 3,000 RPM. Think about your car engine spinning.
I know. That's really fast.
It's crazy fast, right?
Crazy rotation.
It's crazy rotation. What happens? This is like an airplane. Wait. creates drag, which forces the ball down.
Yeah.
And that's why we do this, is to get that spin, pump the ball down. When the ball lands,
it's a higher balance.
And it kicks.
Yeah.
Right? So all of a sudden, your opponent is playing balls up here, out of his comfort zone.
Yeah.
And if he hasn't learned to move up and back to play it in his power zone, then he's just pushing balls back. He's going to push it back short, and then we're going to attack.
Beautiful.
And you hear the difference in the sound when you make good contact?
Good contact.
Yeah. Swing hard. I want you to get used to the fact you can swing hard if you put enough spin on it.
Yeah.
That's almost it. So all I'm doing is if you're swinging slow, I'm moving the contact point here. If you're swinging fast.
Okay.
And that's it. And that's a great shot. You're going to love this. Whoa! You're not going to want to play either. All right. One more. Awesome. All right. So,
I'll gather the ball.
Yeah. So, you pick them up. The easiest thing to do is put them on your racket face. Understand that the pros hit the ball high. And the reason they, because on TV, the camera, is 60 feet high, shooting down, perspective is all wrong. When you go and see a live match, and you're seeing that arc, then you don't hit the ball in the net. But when you hit the ball in the net, you basically said, I didn't want that point. So our only goal is to hit it over. And my joke today is, if I charged you $250, how often would you hit it in
the net?
No, no. Oh, if I was to charge you $250 for every time you hit it in the net, how often would you do it?
None. I'd try not to.
Right. You'd fall on your face not to do it. So some of this is a mental mistake. People trying to hit the ball too low. And the perception, which they don't understand, is that height equals depth. Height over the net equals depth. So you want it deep, you get it high. The lower I hit it to the net, the shorter the ball is. When you hit me a short ball, I'm attacking. Picture. Because I'm aiming for here. But if we're there, they call it out of the cheek test.
Yeah.
So I aim for here.
Yes.
If the ball lands here, where do you think you have to stand to play that reasonably?
Backhand?
Either forehand or backhand.
I'd say about here.
Wait for the back.
Even for the back?
Yeah.
Oh, right, it's going to bounce.
And you can really see it on the clay court.
Yeah.
The guys are back here,
right.
8 to 10 feet behind the baseline, playing balls. Because the ball kicks up on the clay.
Right.
The ball stays a little flatter on this surface. Mm-hmm. But you're gonna see if I hit a deep ball, the ball's right. Gonna be up here. And to get it into your power zone, now you've got to be back here.
Right.
And to hit a ball from here, deep. Look, I hit that pretty hard.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
So height, and part of what we'll talk about is this height, recognizing height equals distance.
Right. Okay.
So at this point, we only want to get it over. And I'm not really going to charge you the $250. Foot should be, I would say, 18 inches to 2 feet at the moment.
point to this direction, you're saying it's about here.
Let's go to the corner.
Okay.
So here's a flight of the ball. I'm going right to the corner. Move your foot back. No, too far.
Oh, you mean, oh yeah, so about here is what you're saying.
Right.
Okay.
So if the flight of the ball is right to the corner, look how close, now do your step.
Yep, okay.
Step out. Longer step towards me.
Longer step.
There, now go out to contact. There, now look down. Look down below, see where that is in relation to the corner. Perfect.
Yeah.
Move your foot back another foot.
This one?
Yeah. Do the same thing. Now, out to the contact point. So now, right now, where you're set up, you would barely hit the end of the racket.
Yeah. Yeah, I'd be like,
you're lunging.
Yeah.
So you've got, with the two-hander, you definitely have to get a little closer to the ball.
Got it.
With your set foot.
Okay.
Because otherwise,
got it.
You're going to be doing this. Butt in the air, flicking at it.
Flicking at it. Got it.
Right.
Okay.
Cool. Okay. No, go back.
Oh, you want it? Oh, okay.
Yeah. So
that was set.
Set?
Set. Hit. Set.
Right.
that contact on practice in the air. So imagine if you got a low ball, drop the racket. Yeah. where the center tee is, except 18 inches behind the baseline. So we're going to cheat a little bit further back in to our ready position. We're not going to come back here. We're going to cheat a little bit to our backhand, because our backhand is arguably a little short. Right? So, and arguably we want to leave our forehand open so that maybe they'll hit more balls to our forehand.
Thank you.
first step off of the center position is going to decide if you get there in time.